sorry, sweetie. I didn't even realize you'd woken up. Morning. I was just busy cleaning your friend off my floor. He's pretty clear though now. I have to say though, he bled a lot of blood. It was more of a pain in the arse than I thought. No worries. It's just finishing actually, so I won't let that keep scaring you and horrifying you. I know you witnessed a murder right in front of your very eyes, but I mean, it was a warning and it's not like it's still there. Besides, we're moving soon anyway. I've been keeping my eye on this very special place, and it's very secluded. Not a lot of people pass, and it will just be us two. Sounds like paradise, don't you think? Excuse me? I'm just gonna pretend that you're still woozy from your glass of water. It's like a nice little cocktail, don't you think? So, I'm thinking I need to give you a bath. I mean, I love you and I love your scent, but I'll tell you a little secret. You're starting to smell just a little. So, I've run you a bath and we're gonna give you a nice wash. It'll be very relaxing for you. I think you deserve it because you were well behaved during my party. Well, you're welcome. Are you ready, my love? Oh, yeah, that's right. We're in the attic. I can't bring you downstairs into my bathroom. I mean, I don't think you're quite ready to enter the rest of the house yet. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring up some warm water. I think it's going to be very, very relaxing. As long as you won't get embarrassed, you will be undressed in front of me. So, I'll be back in just a second. But before I do that, are you thirsty at all? No. Oh, do you remember the song? It was the one that you sang. Can you remember it? Do you remember the time you did the play in the school? I was so happy. Your singing voice is just angelic. Played through my mind on repeat. Every day, every second. Every time I went to fall asleep, I could just hear your beautiful voice going right through my head. I even threatened the principal at the school. Threatened him so he would give me the recording. I did it discreetly. In the end, I just stole it. Not like they'll care. They never, ever appreciated you like I do. Not even close. So, I can play the recording for you tonight and we'll listen to it together because it just Honestly, until I hear that beauty coming out of you again, how am I ever going to be sane? You make me like this. I was never, ever like this before I met you. So you can always remember. You did this to me. Okay, I've got the water and some soap. You're carved, and I just really can't be bothered to undress you, so I'm going to cut your clothing. I mean, I can buy you loads of new clothes, and it's not like anyone's going to see you. I mean, it's just me, and I've seen it all before. I told you. I watch over you all the time. Even when you're in the shower. I was watching you. It's creepy, but one day you'll see me too. We'll see each other. Because we're going to be a family, remember? We have to do certain things to have children of our own. It's gorgeous. Every time I see your bare skin, it turns me on, and I just get very excited. But I know you're not ready for me yet. And as soon as you're ready, we can do whatever you like. I'm sure there are some very freakish things you conjure up in your pretty little head of yours. Okay. And now I'm gonna just clean. I better not start there. I don't want to get you too excited. Lift up your arms for me, sweet. There we go. If it's more comfortable, you can lay back on the bed. It's a sponge bath, and I know how tight I put your handcuffs and the chains, so does hurt, please don't hesitate to lie back. Okay? There we go. Just lift up your arms, spread out your legs. I told you. Don't go all red like that. There is no need to be embarrassed. Okay? I'm sorry. Kiss your chest. It's so broad and it's intoxicating for me. You've been very docile recently. I think the medication I've been giving you is a bit too strong, and I don't think it's left your system yet. So, what we're going to do is I'm going to remove your gag out of your mouth, and we're going to talk. You can ask me questions, because I know so much about you. And you don't know anything about me. And if we're going to live together and have a family together, well then, darling, you need to understand me more. So, I have a proposition. behave yourself and just ask me gentle questions or answer whatever you like. Oh, sorry, just move your leg to the side. Just need to get onto your kneecaps. Got to get every little nook and cranny with you, haven't we? I didn't mean to touch that, I'm sorry. I said I'd leave that till last. I'm not a pervert, thank you very much. I do have manners. Jeez, where do you think I was, raised in a barn? Blimey. Okay. I'm removing your gag now. My hands are a little wet though, okay? Still. There we go. Okay. So, ask away. How did I know you were going to ask that question? That is the most ridiculous question you could have asked me. Complete lunacy. I'm never going to let you go. I told you that. Now, ask me something nicely. And something actually informative. You know, ask me something that's gonna benefit you. You want to get to know me? You will be spending the rest of your life with me. Really? I didn't ask for your life story. I don't care. Well, I care, but I know everything already. Do you seriously not want to know about my past? Okay. Ah. I see. You're wondering where I got this mark on my face. I wear bandages wrapped tightly around my neck. It's an interesting story. You must have seen me before and remember me to know I was never there, right? Well, one night I was following you home because I always wanted to check you were safe. Despite being a lady, I'm very strong and capable. Of course you know that. You've seen it with your own hands. When I was stalking you... Well, stalking's a bit of a strong word. When I was following you, one of your friends noticed me. And he had a gut feeling how dangerous I can be. He became distant from you that night when you went drinking with him. And he was drunk and filled with confidence. And I was in the club watching you guys. In the alleyway. Do you remember the club? You used to walk there with your friends after work and school. And you'd pass by with your fake IDs and walk in the... You're close to age anyway, but you're just as impatient as I am. So, it's no surprise to see you in there with him. When he got drunk, he spotted me. Cornered me. Told you he's buying a drink. In reality, he wanted to talk with me. That bloody bastard, though. He had a pocket knife, and he lunged for me. It was very unexpected. He tripped in the process, and the knife completely slashed my face, catching my neck in the process. I was bleeding. It was everywhere. I was humiliated. Yes. Very, very humiliated. And I couldn't fight back. It was... You would have figured out my plan. So... Instead of calling for help, I ran, and I felt I knew if I waited. Karma would have come out to play. The friend you used to walk with wasn't just one, was it? So who could it have been, I wonder? Do you think I didn't have a motive for killing your friend? You know, the one I've just cleaned up. I have to be careful in the future because we are in an attic. And as disgusting as it is, I may have let it run through the ceiling. It was dripping in my hallway. Ugh. Bloody vile. Absolutely vile. Back to the point. After I ran away from him, I bandaged myself up and took care of my stitches. And that's it. That's why I have this mark on my face and I wear bandages, but I would do it 100 times over if it meant that I could spend this time with you. Okay, I'm gonna clean your delicate area now. You can always ask me anything, you know that, right? Anything you want. Let me just... What was that, sweetheart? Why have I fallen for you? Well, I thought I made that clear already. You're very talented. And you're so kind, like I said. Do you remember the time you were walking home with your friends? You spotted a girl. She was being pushed around by boys, and they were doing all sorts of awful things to her. Well, it was obviously me. But you had no fear. You tackled them. And you helped me up. I'm sorry, I just get very emotional. I'm sorry. You took my hand. And you helped me up, and you told me everything was going to be okay, and I was so scared. Oh, composure, please. Oh, get a hold of yourself. Anyway, sorry, I get very emotional. You took my hand, that was it. I was a goner. And I love you more than anything. And I told you, you wouldn't have to be restrained like you are now if you would just give in to me. I would take so much care of you. You don't even realize. I'm doing this because I love you, and I want to protect you. We're just going to be together forever. My darling. Forever. Okay. No, don't squirm. I told you I'm cleaning this area, but please don't squirm. Okay. Would you mind? Hard to clean your back when you're let down. Sorry, sweetie, could you just sit up for me? Thank you, Angel. There we go. Okay, I'm just gonna clean your back. We will move soon. Don't worry. distant. I thought we talked about this just now. We're opening up to each other. We're having a fucking moment, and you're just completely destroying it. Enough. I mean it, enough. Stop bloody shouting. All right, I'm so sorry about this. Pete's sake, I'm sorry. I was trying to have a lovely, beautiful moment with you, but it appears that you don't want that right now. Oh, do you know what? You have ticked me off so much that I'm sorry. You're going to lie there naked now. I'm going to do something very stupid. And you're going to be in bloody tears. You're going to be in so much despair. I'm only trying to be nice by giving you a wash and opening up. Gag's back on now. It's your bloody fault for shouting. I'm really going to have to move us quickly now. If anyone heard that, it's over. Next time I won't be so bloody stupid, will I? I love you, but remember your threat towards your mother and father? Well, that's coming into play. And you only have yourself to blame. How stupid can you be? I was just praising you about how clever you are. You went and fucked it, didn't you? Well, no more. I'm not being played for a fool. Get ready to lose something you really, really love, because it's gonna be gone in less than an hour. And I'll bring back a lovely little souvenir for you. Okay, darling. This is on you. You can lie there. And when I come back, I'll bring you a beautiful present. Before I go, I'm gonna leave you here with the restraints more tight than ever. Ta-ta, sweetheart. And you're going to be so shocked. Maybe I can break you. If you're not going to give in to me, I'll break you down mentally until you love me.